Hey, good evening, High Point family. PMike here, coming to you from my den. I have a fire behind me to have us in a nice setting tonight. I hope that this time together finds you well and all of your family doing okay on this, what someone said this morning, on this next Groundhog Day is what it feels like. But thank you for tuning in tonight and being here. I have got Tilly over here by my side, our lab, and y'all have heard stories about Tilly. And I've got the smell of fresh out of the oven cinnamon bread tonight for communion. So how is that for making you just a little jealous? Oh my goodness, look at all the folks that are already tuning in. So glad to have you. And I, again, let me just say, I have missed you folks so much. I know you have missed each other, and I'm glad, I'm thankful for technology that we can just have this time together. I'd like to offer a prayer, and then I have a little bit of housekeeping that I want to go through with you. And then I want to share a couple of fun things and then move into just a very brief teaching tonight, some things that are on my heart, as well as sharing communion. So let me ask you to make sure that you have either bread or crackers or something that you can use for dipping. I've enjoyed the pictures the last couple weeks. This is our third communion time. You've sent some really fun pictures. I've seen people using all kinds of things for communion, and we know that it is not about what we use. It is about the heart, and God knows our hearts. And we ask God to. I even saw a power drink, I think, but we ask God just to bless this time. Especially this season of uncertainty. We ask God just to be present with us tonight and just to use this time, first and foremost, to glorify Him. And then secondly, to hopefully just to bring encouragement and comfort to your heart tonight. If you're watching a lot of news, I would encourage you not to do that. I am trying to watch less and less, maybe get a report in the morning and a report in the evening. We need to know what's going on. There's all kind of folks tuning in. But let's pray. And before I get too many more rabbit trails, High Point family, you know all about rabbit trails. And so let's pray if we might. Lord God, we thank you for this beautiful day. Thank you for the blue skies today. Thank you for the sunrise. Thank you for the cool breeze today, this morning. Thank you for the coolness tonight that allows me to have a fire in the fireplace without burning up. How nice to be able to warm up around the fire, but also to warm up as the body of Christ and to warm up around your spirit. God, you are our comforter, your Holy Spirit, especially during this season. And for this few minutes that we have together tonight, God, I pray that it be whatever you intend for it to be. And whoever is watching, whoever is listening, whether they're a part of our High Point family or whether they're family or friends or neighbors, whoever they may be, coming in long distance, God, just bless this time, anoint this time, use this time, and truly let it be honoring to you and let it bring great, great encouragement on this Wednesday evening, April 1st. God, we love you. We thank you. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you for your Holy Spirit. And we thank you for this season. And we ask your blessings over this time. And we ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Let me share a just a couple of little housekeeping things, if I might, First, I want to say that we have kind of locked in after going back and forth. We've kind of locked in on YouTube Live. We find that it's pretty easy to get to and accessible. Rick Ross twisted my arm, and not really, but it seems to be, once I learned to use it, it seemed to be a pretty good place to go to. We've been toggling all over the place, just trying to find the best platforms to share with you scripture and encouragement and what is going on as far as our online meetings. So I hope that I hope you were able, if you're watching this tonight, then obviously you found it. But let me encourage you, if you've not signed up for the e-blast, sending out some great links through the e-blast. I'm sending it out twice a week. It's as simple as going to the church website, highpointccop.com, and submitting your name and address. And I promise we won't send people to your house because we're not allowed to. That was a little joke. But we do want to stay in contact with you. And so we're dropping links everywhere just to make sure that you're staying in touch. I want to give another shout out to just give props to Rick for the work he's been doing, and also for our praise team for that great music on Sunday. We had to remove it because of copyright issues, licensing issues. You can go and you can listen to the interview that I did with my brother, but we do have to be aware of copyright issues. And just one more thank you to Donnie and Johnny, who have been so generous in sharing their music with us. Two very powerful gospel songs, and just really appreciate their willingness to share. This coming Sunday is Palm Sunday. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna. I shared something on Facebook that was just an idea, not my idea, of putting palms on the front door, or making palm crosses to display on the front door or to display in your home. And a number of you like that idea. And so on our church Facebook page, we've been sharing some information about that, but very simply, Michael Gant, we received the normal palm branches that we receive for Palm Sunday, and we're going to make those available. We're going to put them in a basket out in front of the church, and some of you have also said you're willing to, you have palm branches, you have palms, and you're willing to share those. Try to communicate that information to you through our Facebook pages, through our e-blast, through our website. So keep checking there as far as that. I think we have Bishop Grant joining us tonight from Jamaica. If you're out there, Bishop Grant, we say welcome to you. I haven't been looking over here to see your name pop up, it was nice to talk to the bishop, and he called me today to find out what time we were going to be online. So if you're with us, Michael, we say welcome. Well, listen, this is April 1st, and none of us are in the mood for, you're probably not in the mood for April Fool's jokes, but I did have some things that shot across my Facebook page today, some things that that just made me chuckle, and I wanted to share a couple of those things with you. This was a social distance baptism, and I'm going to hold it up so you can see exactly what it looks like. I think you can tell from that. It is a pastor with a super soaker, and a dad is holding a baby at a safe distance. That made me chuckle. And then this one, several of you commented on this today, and just like that, my pastor became a tele-evangelist. And you probably read that backwards. My response to that post today And just like that, Sally said no when I turned in a voucher for a jet and a baptismal jacuzzi. And then this one just made me chuckle. May Evancheck, you are adorable. I don't know what was going on here, but when I turned on, this was just a little while ago, I turned on my computer and this just made me laugh. I want to share it with you tonight. My pastor is doing it online Sunday. My pastor is doing it online Sunday. And then it says, and tonight at 8 p.m. is communion online. So, May, you are adorable. I don't know what was being said there. I'm not really sure what I'm doing, but that gets the chuckle of the day. I love that. So May, miss you, and I miss all of you. And but that in particular made me smile. Well, what I'd like to do tonight, I want to share a little bit. I want to share from a reading that I know very well, and then I want to share from a book that I grabbed, of all people, from Sadie Robertson. And I'll explain that to you in just a few minutes. We're going to share communion, and then I want to share with you something that I feel like God impressed on my heart today, and just offer that up in closing tonight. But this reading is called A Gracious Uncertainty. And I've shared it over the years with a number of people. I've shared it with the staff at one time on a staff retreat. But it really does speak to waiting. It's from My Utmost for His Highest. And I believe it is, I want to say it's the April 15th or April 25th reading. But if you go online and simply type in A Gracious Uncertainty by Oswald Chambers, you can very easily find this. So here's the reading. The scripture is 1 John 3:2. It has not been revealed what we shall be. Think about that for just that verse alone. It has not yet been revealed what we shall be. Our natural inclination is to be so precise, trying always to forecast accurately what will happen next, that we look upon uncertainty as a bad thing. We think that we must reach some predetermined goal, but that is not the nature of the spiritual life. The nature of the spiritual life is that we are certain in our uncertainty. And I just right there, if I could pause, I just want to offer that as a word of encouragement to you. Even in these uncertain times, there are plenty of things that we are certain about. Amen? I just heard a big group amen out there. Consequently, we do not put down roots. Our common sense says, well, what if I were in that circumstance? We cannot presume to see ourselves in any circumstance in which we have never been. And goodness gracious, we're in circumstances today that we never would have imagined. Certainty is the mark of the common sense life. Gracious uncertainty is the mark of the spiritual life. To be certain of God means that we are uncertain in all our ways, not knowing what tomorrow may bring. Woo! This is generally expressed with a sigh of sadness, but it should be an expression of breathless expectation. We're uncertain of the next step, but we are certain of God. As soon as we abandon ourselves to God and do the task He has placed closest to us, He begins to fill our lives with surprises. When we become simply a promoter or a defender of a particular belief, something within us dies. That's not believing God. It is only believing our belief about Him. Jesus said, "Unless you become as little children." The spiritual life is the life of a child. We're not uncertain of God, just uncertain of what he is going to do next. If our certainty is only in our beliefs, we develop a sense of self-righteousness, becoming overly critical, and are limited by the view that our beliefs are complete and settled. But when we have the right relationship with God, life is full of spontaneous, joyful uncertainty and expectancy. Jesus said, "Believe also in me, not believe certain things about me. Leave everything to him, and it will be gloriously and graciously uncertain how he will come in, but you can be certain that he will come. Remain faithful to him." And those last couple of lines, when our staff met on retreat, we broke this entire thing down and we talked about it almost sentence by sentence. But that last line in particular, leave everything to him, and it will be gloriously and graciously uncertain how he will come in, but you can be certain that he will come. Remain faithful to him. Remain faithful to him. We've got to remember that, folks. We have got to especially during this season of uncertainty. When we have Jesus, we have a gracious uncertainty, a gracious uncertainty. So how does Sadie Robertson figure into all this? Sadie is part of the Robertson clan, the Duck Dynasty group. And we've heard her speak with our students on our winter retreat. I think we might've heard her at Catalyst. She actually is she's a great Bible teacher. And I was going to be speaking to the students a couple weeks ago on True Love Waits, and she has a chapter in her book. The book is titled Live, and the chapter in this book is called Don't Waste the Waiting. So I grabbed this thinking I could get some good stuff from Sadie. And I'm not going to read to you Sadie's writings. It's actually a kind of a fun little book. And like I said, she's a great Bible teacher. But she did say several things that I would like to share with you. She said, she made this comment, "I think it's important to talk about waiting in our lives." And she shares two practical ways to get through a waiting season without wasting it. And the first thing that she says is that we need to focus on our relationship with God. Well, that is for us that follow Christ and profess our faith in Christ. That is kind of a no-brainer. I don't know about you, but we do have time right now. I have time. Extra time to spend in study and prayer. I hope you're maximizing this time in some way in that area. She mentions Isaiah 40:29. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Deuteronomy 31:8. The Lord goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Psalm 34:10. The lions may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. And finally, the verse that we just talked about on Sunday, John 10:10, the thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. So the first thing that she says to make sure that we're not wasting our waiting is to focus on your relationship with God. And then she says, focus on what you already have. That's good advice. Focus on what you already have. And she gave a challenge, and I'm issuing this to myself at the end of this chapter. I'm issuing it to you tonight. I challenge you, she says, to take your phone or a piece of paper and make a list of everything good in your life. Include all the seemingly little things. For example, do you have shoes on your feet? How good was the ice cream you ate last night before bed? She said, do that a few times and make the list as long as you possibly can. As you think about these things and all the other blessings in your life, thank God for them. You may not think of these simple things as blessings, but I've been many places in the world where people do not have these things in their day-to-day life, yet they are grateful and still alive. So you get the idea. But one of the other things she said, that instead of using the word waiting, we need to substitute the word believing. Instead of waiting, we need to substitute the word waiting. So there you have your homework. Number one, to focus on your relationship with God. Number two, make a list, focus on what you already have. And number three, every time you think about the word waiting, use the word believing instead. Amen? Amen. All right. We want to share communion tonight. And I can't tell you how special this time has been. And so I'm going to give you just a few minutes to, I think I might have a little bit of music that I want to bring up here and give you a minute to gather around your communion table and make sure everything is ready. We've got some amens going on there. Love and miss my HPCC family. Woo! Isn't that the truth? I'm going to ask my sound tech to turn that up just a little bit. Thank you, sound tech. Okay, I've got the bread for the Haley family. I want you to take a look at that, folks. It look good?
Jesus, Jesus.
On the night in which he gave himself up for us. Sound tech, could you turn that down just a hair? I've got the dog and the cat lining up. Okay. Communion's going to be interesting tonight. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. And you know this, so say it with me. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Let's say that together. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with your Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen and amen. Join me in the Lord's Prayer, if you would, please. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen and amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Praise be to God. Let's say that together. The gifts of God for the people of God. Praise be to God. Amen. Listen to the music, and then you share communion with your family and friends, and then we'll come back together. Body of Christ, which is broken for you.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him.
Blood of Christ, which is shed for you, for the forgiveness of your sins.
Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Oh, for grace to trust him more.
Amen. Amen. I know that was a sweet time for you. I'm just going to let the music continue to play. And I want to share with you, today I was pressure washing the house, and we're going to all have beautiful homes, beautiful residences when this is over. I was pressure washing, and I was thinking, this just dropped in my spirit. I don't say God told me, because I don't like to say God told me, but this just was impressed on my spirit today. And this word came to me, and I want to offer it up to you because of the time in which we are living right now. 1 John 4:1 says, "Dear friends, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see whether they are from God, because many false prophets have gone out into this world." This is how you can recognize the Spirit of God. "Every spirit that acknowledges that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is from God. But every spirit that does not acknowledge Jesus is from God, this is the spirit of the Antichrist, which you have heard is coming, and even now is already in the world. Dear children, you are from God and have overcome them, because the one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world." The one who is in you, child of God, is greater than the one who is in the world. It's greater than the virus. It's greater than all the uncertainties. It's greater than all that's going on right now, and all the things where it looks like there is no control, and there are great questions about what is going to happen in these next few days. I want you to know, and I say this at High Point all the time, I want you to know that God is still on the throne, and nothing catches God by surprise. He doesn't look down and go, "Whoops, that one got by me." God loves you wherever you are tonight, your friends, your family. And what a great season to be growing in our knowledge of him. But the other thing that I want to say to you is that this is a season where there might be a lot of voices out there saying a lot of different things. And I just want to offer a word of encouragement to you. A word of warning, if there's folks that you're listening to or reading and they have a fresh revelation about what's going on, just be very, very careful who you're listening to. My Bible has a book in it called the Book of Revelations. And so if somebody says they have a fresh word or a fresh this or a fresh that, you be careful. You be careful. You make sure you run everything through the Word of God. Make sure you know the voice of the shepherd, because as his sheep, he knows our voice and we know his. And if you don't know his voice, this is a great season to spending time getting to know more and more of his voice. Let me end on a very encouraging, what I thought was a very encouraging word. It was someone shared it today as a meme, and just, you can just read those big words. It says, not everything is canceled. Not everything is canceled. I love this because I'm a glass half full kind of guy. I think y'all know that about me. The sun is not canceled. Let's do it like this, okay? Because I want to have some little interaction here with you. I'm going to announce the things that are not canceled, and I want you to go, not canceled, okay? So when I say these things, I want you to go, not canceled, okay? So here we go. The sun, not canceled. Springtime, not canceled. Relationships, not canceled. Love, not canceled. Reading, not canceled. Devotion, not canceled. Music, not canceled. Imagination, not canceled. Kindness, not canceled. Conversations, not canceled. Hope, not canceled. Coffee, not canceled. Barking dogs, not canceled. And Pastor Mike's goofy sense of humor. Everybody say it together. Not canceled. God bless you. Thanks for tuning in tonight for Fireside Communion. Love you guys so much. And we've got some surprises over the next couple weeks. We've got something very special planned for October. That was a joke. That was a joke. But be sure and tune in Sunday morning at 9 o'clock for Palm Sunday. And then we might have another special night of prayer as well. So be watching for that. I'll make sure that you know about that. Really want to pray for our teachers who are doing online work right now and our children and students. And tonight I would also lift up special prayers for the Doherty family. Leanne's dad needs our prayers tonight. And she is, if you would please lift up Lou and Leanne, keep them in your prayers. Thank you so much. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you his peace. And all God's people said, oh, I didn't hear you.
Amen.
There we go. God bless you and have a good night.